Hi lovelies, it's me Sherry with Live Love Latte, and thanks for joining me for this organization video. Today I'm going to show you my hospitality bin. I've always put stuff together that I use to entertain guests and impromptu guests, but after watching a video from At Home with Nikki and Bree's project book, I decided to organize it just a little bit better, and I will put the links to their videos in the description box below. For now, this is just one bin in my pantry. After I reorganize and redecorate my dining room, I will be putting all of my entertaining stuff in the dining room. So this will be going there once that's finished. I labeled the bin with this cute little chalkboard clip that I got from a friend for my birthday, and it says here, inspire others. She gave me these three packs, and I chose the one from this pack, and on the back it says Big Lots, and they were $2. When I was organizing this bin, the first thing I thought about was, what are the items that I really want to put in here, which would be really easy to put together for impromptu guests and last minute people coming over, which happened last week. My husband told me, hey, so-and-so's coming over, and I had about 10 minutes to set up a little hospitality bar for them. So on the back, I just have this 8.5 by 11 piece of paper that I printed from my computer and laminated. It is titled Hospitality Bin, and I just put the definition up here in the front. The friendly and generous reception and entertainment of guests, visitors, or strangers. So that it just reminds me why I put these things together for people. And here on the front part, it is things that I always want on hand, and on the back are the ones that I find are optional. So what I did when I was putting this list together was to really think about, what are the easy things and the most basic things that I can serve, and how many of those items do I want to serve at any given time. So here I have at least one grains, and I have here fresh baguette, multi-grain crackers, fresh French bread. Then I have at least one coffee or hot chocolate accompaniment, which is like a biscotti. And then one spread, like fig spread, jam, hummus, spinach artichoke dip. Then two types of fresh fruit. And then at least one cold beverage. And then at least one coffee flavor, four hot tea choices. And then the different stuff that I need for coffee and tea. So the reason I did this was to make sure that those are always ready, that I always have a supply. On the other side, I have the optional items. Example, cheese, like Gouda, Gruyere, Gorgonzola. And those are the ones that I normally serve. I usually serve a semi-hard cheese and a soft cheese. And then I also like to, as an option, serve a deli meat like prosciutto or hard salami or Genoa salami. And then I also like to serve raw nuts like cashews, almonds, pistachio. Then dried fruits or crudités, a dipping oil, and then a mini dessert. And you can see here, I put all at least one, at least one, at least one, and then maybe an alcoholic beverage. And then I just put little clip art here and there just to make the list a little bit more visually interesting. So I tried to pack things in here as neatly and as orderly as possible. This is a two-tier tray, and I do have a setting for four people. Those are just mini servers, and underneath are plates. These are the dishes that I keep in here. Like I said earlier, the two-tier tray, two white rectangular servers, the four dipping sauce servers, and then four dessert plates. I have multi-grain crackers and rice crackers. And then there's individually wrapped chocolate biscotti, a pumpkin spice Milano cookie, and then the European biscuits with a little bit of milk chocolate. Then there's microwave popcorn, fig spread, and black olive tapenade. And I do have on hand strawberries, mangoes in the refrigerator, and apple smoked Gruyere cheese and dill Havarti. My coffee bar, hot tea, hot chocolate, even hot apple cider is always well stocked. And the drawer right here by the coffee bar is always ready to serve guests. I don't have a lot of bottles, but I do like to make sure I have at least one or two bottles of red, white, and sparkling wine ready to serve. And then I have a mini refrigerator specifically for beverages. And then lastly, I like to keep frozen appetizers in this container from the Container Store that is slim and compact, and ones that just take about 15 to 20 minutes to heat up in the toaster oven. I hope you enjoyed this video of my simple organization of my hospitality bin. Please leave a comment below and let me know what else I should add to this, and I will see you next time. Bye! please subscribe to my channel, Live Love Latte, and join me on my daily adventures as a mompreneur.